हेलो एवरीवन, यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 881 एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज द बेसिक रॉ मटेरियल्स फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ सिरेमिक, फॉर द मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ सिरेमिक। मेनली थ्री बेसिक रॉ मटेरियल्स आर देयर। वन इज कॉल्ड प्लास्टिक मटेरियल एंड दैट प्लास्टिक मटेरियल इज नथिंग बट क्ले। सेकेंड सिलिका which provides the rigidity, and third one is mineralization, means aluminium or rock minerals which are used. These three are the main ingredients for the preparation of ceramic. And ceramic, you know, chemically it contains oxides and some other carbides are there, and they are making it strong. The processes are like that. First, once it is prepared, then there is drying process. Drying process is the most important, and there are some processes in the stages for careful drying, because if the mixed material is not properly dried, then the product will be having some cracking. So drying is most important, and after that then firing, means at suitable temperature we have to heat it to make it very hard after dehydration. And then glazing means on the upper surface of this some transparent coating is done. And especially those wares which are used as a table wares or some other tiles, the glazing process is very, very important. So these are all processes I will be discussing one by one. So basic raw materials for manufacture of ceramics. Number one, the components present in ceramic such as oxides and carbides. These two are very important component which are providing the hard rigid structure for ceramics etc., which give high chemical stability to ceramics. They are resistant to high oxidizing and reducing atmospheres. I mean the oxidation and reduction by air, by atmosphere, is drastically reduced because of the presence of these carbide and oxides. The ceramics are transparent to a wide range of wavelength regions. The optical properties of ceramics depends upon its composition and crystal structure. So the optical properties, reflection, reflective property depends upon the type of crystals formed in the ceramics. Number two, the basic raw materials is divided into three basic groups, and these three basic groups are: number one, that is known as plastic material. Plastic material is nothing but it is your clay. Number two, that is non-plastic material. Non-plastic material is, that is your silica. And third one is mineralization. Mineralization means it is your feldspar. Feldspar is a type of rock, of aluminium rock, and aluminium silicate we can say, sometimes bauxite. These are mineral rocks, and with the help of these mineral rocks, the ceramics are mineralized. So these three are the most important or basic raw materials used for the manufacture of ceramics. Number three, drying process. Once all the raw materials are mixed and it is manufactured, the first step goes drying, and drying is very important step, and there are some techniques used. Drying articles made by following mentioned methods and materials are dried well before they are found fit for firing. So first they have to do the drying before they are going for firing. Drying is most important because imperfect drying may cause cracking of the articles during firing. There are mainly three types of dryers which are widely used. A is, that is called intermittent dryer, and this intermittent dryer is hot floor compartment chamber. So it is a hot floor big compartment chamber, that is called intermittent dryer. B is semi-continuous dryer. It is dubbing dryer chamber. And C is, that is called your continuous dryer. It is a tunnel dryer. So these three type of dryers are used to dry the articles. So here, number four, that is the process of firing. After drying of the articles, we go for firing. The action of heat on clay and the mixture of clay with other materials is really the basis of ceramic industry. And the dried articles are known as blanks. And these blanks are fired to produce biscuits or biscuit, and during firing process the chemical and physical changes takes place. Number five, after firing there we follow the process that is known as glazing. Glazing is the coating very carefully. Glazing is an important process in white wares and table wares. A glaze is a thin coating of glass that is melted onto the surface of ceramic material, and glaze is applied on the surface to cover the pores which are present in all classes of ceramics except one, and that is called hard porcelain. So in hard porcelain glazing is not applicable because it is not having any pore. Otherwise in all other ceramics pore is there and that coating is possible. Number six, frist. After glazing, the preparation of frist is very important for glaze. The suitable lower than 1200 degree centigrade temperature. Glaze are applied to the surface of ceramic articles in the form of powder particles suspended in water. The various fluxes such as soda ash, boric acid and borax are converted into non-water soluble substance by mixing them with silica and heating the mixture at its above the melting point it is applied. So, with this I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.